Two sofas bought for me.
A MacBook Pro.
Nice jewellery like Dolce & Gabbana.
Lots of pairs of designer shoes.
Some diamond Tiffany earrings.
Cash, which is always great, it's better than gifts.
Oh, what else have I had?
A car.
Cake mixing machines.
Two Chanel watches.
Nice rings.
A necklace, an anklet.
Holidays.
Whatever it is I want, they will go and buy me.
With Britain in the grip of recession, most women are resigning themselves to having to skimp on their heart's desires.
Cheers, bitches.
A new breed of women are exploiting men's weaknesses and relying on their charms to get whatever they want.
Ta-da!
They're called rinsers.
My outgoings are completely paid for.
From life's luxuries to paying the gas bill, they keep rinsing.
We want it to make as much money as we can.
This is the real hustle.
Fake tan, big boobs and false eyelashes are all part of the game.
This is about 1400.
And today's new technology enables these rinsers to work men at the touch of a button.
This holds the key. It just reels them in.
We meet the ladies who are living this life to the full and who are doing it on their terms.
And I'm a lot happier being in charge.
They tell the men that sex is never part of the deal. This is the golden rule of rinsing.
Is your scarf that you asked for?
The guy's wallet stays open, but the girl's legs remain firmly closed.
I'm pretty sure most guys would like it to be more, but it doesn't mean it's going to happen, does it?
A kiss on the hand may be quite continental, but diamonds are a girl's best friend.
33-year-old Jeanette Worthington is from Liverpool.
Can I have those in a five, please?
Yeah, of course, you can, just one minute.
She loves shopping for luxury items.
How much are these?
These are £420.
But as an experienced rinser, she doesn't have to pay for her designer goods.
I need them.
The jacket, the bag, the shoes, and my watch have been bought for me.
I think they're about 5,000, maybe six.
Her phone is her main tool. It has the contact details of wealthy men she's met in exclusive bars and clubs.
Is that all right to take a picture of them?
Yeah, that's fine.
I'm going to put that picture on my profile for my BlackBerry Messenger. Some of the guys on there who I'm friends with will see it and ask me about them. I'll get a message or something. Are they Jimmy Choo's? Oh, they look fabulous on you. And I'll be like, oh my God, do they really? Maybe you think I need them? 9 times out of 10, I'll probably get them.
If one of the men on her contacts list does buy her the Jimmy Choo's, Jeanette makes it clear that she is only offering friendship in return, because rinsers have a rule, no sex.
I'm careful at the beginning. When I first meet people, I don't give them the wrong impression. And it doesn't really tend to go that way. You know, I do nice things for my friends. I don't expect them to have sex with me because I do anything for them, so I don't see why they should expect that.
It's crazy, baby, but it works.
Come on in. This is the gorgeous man of my dreams. And the only man in my life, Willie.
Little Willie's owner, Danica Thrall, is a model who doesn't get out of bed for anything less than a Lads Mag cover shoot. Unlike Jeanette, she never even meets the men she rinses.
Good boy!
Danica is rinsing royalty.
Okay, so all of these here are all the newest gifts that I've received. Ta-da! Little trousers. This is the most favourite of mine. This is, I believe, about 1400. That's Agent Provocateur. This was 850 there. It's pretty amazing how it's all been bought.
Danica is a successful model and Twitter is helping her become an internet entrepreneur.
You know, if you could put a figure on what you have so far, what would you say?
Must be 20 grand. £20,000 in the last few months, I'd say. Twitter's really important, actually. If it wasn't for Twitter, I don't think I would have got half the things that I have, because I'm constantly posting on Twitter.
When some of Danica's 10,000 followers began offering to buy her gifts, she saw a business opportunity.
I didn't respond to them to begin with, and then I actually thought, do you know what, I actually think there's a big market for this, and it would actually benefit me and them in some way. So that's how I came up with the idea of the gifts.
As a reward for sending Danica gifts, most followers are happy with a sweet tweet from their favourite cover girl.
Usually you do have to be topless, but I try and get away with as little as possible. My fan base really, really like that kind of thing.
And can you tell me, what have you had done to your body?
The only thing I've had done is I've had a breast augmentation. And people always ask me if I've had my lips done, always. My sister's got huge lips. We've always had really, really big lips. So yeah, just had the breasts done.
Why do you think guys do this?
Guys have all kinds of fantasies and things that they find a bit of a turn on, really. And I think one of them is this, buying gifts for girls.
Twenty-year-old Holly Capper works as a dancer in nightclubs. She also makes sure that she enjoys men's generosity. Holly has only recently discovered rinsing, the art of getting gifts from men and promising nothing physical in return.
I got this last night. It's a nice bottle of Cristal champagne. A friend who lives down south, we keep in touch, and he gives me some nice gifts, like my champagne. This is one of my stranger presents, also one of my favourite. His name's Simba and he's a husky. I got speaking to a guy and he mentioned that he bred huskies. And I was like, I'd really like a husky. And a few weeks later, I had a little knock on the door and there he was.
And do you still see the guy?
No, I don't see the guy anymore. You know, if I'm not getting something that I need or that I want, I've got no need for that friendship or for that guy.
While luxury gifts are always welcome, Holly's priority is getting cash to cover her household bills.
Bills, that's not something I want to pay for, so I'm not going to pay for it. So, yeah, the guys that I date, they all have a little duty to all pay, you know, some of it. They date me for my appearance, and the way I keep that up is by them paying for it. So I think it's a fair trade, definitely. I prefer the old-fashioned days where the guys go out and work and the women just sit at home and look pretty.
Holly's not paying the bills just for herself. She has another mouth to feed.
DJ is my little boy. He's just turned two. And he was quite an unexpected arrival. I never really thought I'd have kids quite so young. But, yeah, I wouldn't change him for the world now. My mum was quite sad. She thought me having a baby would mean I'd have to give up my career and my dreams and things like that. And I was like, no. Like, the whole time I was pregnant, I was like, it's not going to happen and I'm still going to achieve what I wanted to. And I worked up until the day before I had CJ. When I come home and I see his, like, little happy face and I brought him, like, some new toys or something, he, like, definitely makes it worthwhile. Life is on the game. I think everything you're doing it is a game. You know, you have to know how to play men to get what you want out of life, definitely.
I can't explain the type of man, but there is a type of man.
They're mainly businessmen.
Expensive clothes.
Maybe a divorce.
Usually bored.
That's generally who they are.
If I go out, I can now think he's one of them.
If somebody finds a young one, that's quite rare.
I think he's definitely one of them.
Like a four-leaf clover.
At an exclusive hotel in London's Knightsbridge, Jeanette and two friends are getting ready for an evening of rinsing men.
Champagne's here.
Thank you.
Just what the doctor ordered.
The girls are going out to hunt for wealthy guys who will shower them with expensive trinkets. They all know the drill.
What is that on your wrist, darling? I haven't seen that before.
Where did you get that? Show me.
It's the new edition.
Oh, my Cartier. God. Cartier, yeah. Darling. Fabulous.
Fill the beans now.
Oh, well, I was in Hilton and this guy was sat there looking over. So we got chatting and he said, would you like to have dinner with me? So I was just like, yeah, OK. And he went, would you like me to bring a present? So I told him that I'd lost my Rolex at Christmas.
Oh, as you do.
Standard. I hadn't, it's at home. Yeah. So he said, how about a nice Cartier, darling? And I was like, oh,
oh
yes.
God.
That's just what the doctor ordered. It's lovely, isn't
looks
it?
Looks expensive, babe, definitely.
Tiffany's.
Jeanette's Cartier man is just the type of generous guy they're after.
Cartier.
Other men they've met in bars have taken their orders for designer bags, shoes, exotic holidays, and even a spot of plastic surgery.
Right, girls, need your opinion. This dress.
Hello.
You look sexual.
Cool beans.
Is your tan real, or have you got a spray tan?
Oh, sunbeds.
That's real.
I've been caned in the sunbeds.
That's real.
That's as real as we get.
And we are going to mingle and possibly meet some future lucrative friends.
You know. Stop beating around the fucking bush. She's looking for like a rich guy to pay her fucking bills, right? She can say all these big words all day long, but in basic terms, she wants a motherfucker to pay her bills.
Because we're in a group, we're a pack.
The pack of wolves.
We're the wolf pack.
The wolf pack.
Jeanette and her friends are stalking London's most lucrative haunts. They're part of a new breed of women called rincers, who charm expensive gifts out of men while sticking to their own rule of no sex.
It's like if a lion sees the herd and then they see one of them's got a bandy leg. We'll see a pack of businessmen, clothes, whatever, watches, and then we'll wheedle out one that's a little bit naive.
What do you guys do? You're dressed very well.
I'm going for the girl.
What about this?
We like a cocktail.
Oh, cosmopolitan, please. Thank you.
But this is about as hot as things get for these guys.
Mate, they're looking to get their leg over. I ain't gonna
A light rinse of drinks to whet their appetite, and then it's on to their next targets.
Oh, thanks, Ali.
As soon as Jeanette finds a wealthy guy, she adds him to her phone contacts. Then she can let him know what gifts she wants through hints on her phone's messenger service.
So you've cast the net out in the bar, you've got the pin, you start your statuses. You want to go on holiday, or you want to go shopping, or you need a hotel for something, or whatever.
Thank you.
Then the games begin.
150 miles away, another game is about to begin.
It's too darn hot.
Holly Kappa is out to snare a similar prey. A generous guy with deep pockets.
I like to think of myself as like a modern day geisha. You know, they're entertainers and they do the dancing and things like that for the guys. And I think that's a bit similar to what I do.
Holly works at Mansfield nightclub Wonderland. She's paid to dress up to entice people into the club on a quiet Wednesday night. This is Holly's main source of income, but it's also a chance to line up men to rinse.
Tonight is quite a good opportunity to meet potential dates. So in between working, I also get to look around and see if there's any talent, check out the bars and things like that. So, you know, it's definitely a good way to catch guys' eyes, definitely.
As a stilts walker, Holly should easily spot the millionaires of Mansfield.
First. You all right, lads? Going to Wonderland tonight? Hey, Wonderland tonight, ladies? I'll be dancing in Wonderland. Are you going to come and watch me?
Yeah, okay.
I work here quite regularly and you see quite local people. But I've seen a few guys tonight who I've not seen around here before, which is quite nice.
Yeah!
In your dreams. My main aim of the night is to come out of it with some contact details, a phone number or Facebook details, and then do my detective work. I'll see, you know, where they work, and I'll check their pictures, see where they've been, maybe on holiday, And from there, I can kind of work out if they've got money.
You two look very nice this evening.
Thank you.
And if I think, you know, they've possibly got potential, then that's where we would maybe exchange phone numbers or something like that.
I think you should give me a hug and warm me up.
What the? Oh, do you want me to warm your leg up?
Oh, yeah, that's the one that fucking works.
There's two of you. You can warm the leg up each. That's better. They look quite interesting characters, though, so I think that's definitely a Facebook swap. I wouldn't know whether they've got big money until I've done my research.
The main rule for me is I never, ever meet any of the people I speak to.
I never take it beyond a friendship, so I would never sleep with a guy for money or anything like that.
Don't sleep with these guys.
No sexual talk, no interaction.
No emotions involved whatsoever.
People probably don't believe all of that, whatever else. Not really asked. It's the truth.
It's one big game.
They get literally the pleasure of my company. They get my time.
It's my way, or the highway.
And I think that's more than worthy of a nice check or a present.
Rinsing cash and gifts from guys without sleeping with them takes a special sort of girl. Jeanette Worthington's looks certainly help charm the men and get her work as a glamour model under the name Holly Henderson. But she always has the tools of the rinsing trade to hand.
Yeah, BlackBerry Messenger is called BBM, and now girls use it to their advantage. It used to be Facebook. Whereas people would meet on Facebook and talk on Facebook now, it's the BBM.
It's handheld now. It's with you all the time. This holds the key to everything.
They just put statuses on.
Yeah.
Hint, hint, hint. It's called damsel in distress.
Damsel in distress syndrome.
Works every time.
Her BBM has the contacts of some of the country's richest guys, and she has been papped on the arm of Premiership footballer Mario Balotelli.
Don't like him, do you?
You know, Balotelli.
Yeah.
What's funny about him is he was after me one week and after her the next.
Yeah.
And he didn't even know us. We didn't know, did we?
We never, ever had sex. And kissed twice, I think. That's about it.
Well, he got loads of abuse off me, so.
But Jeanette is more than a pretty face.
Perfect.
She's a mum of two boys and is studying forensic psychology at Liverpool Hope University.
I've always been intrigued in psychology, the way people behave and the way you can predict people's behaviour and things like that by understanding psychology. Because everybody just thinks that they do things and they're dead unique and that nobody can read them and nobody knows what they're going to do and everything they do is just off the cuff kind of thing, but it isn't.
For Jeanette, an understanding of the male psyche is crucial to set up the perfect rinse.
You'll sit at the bar, I'll read a book, somebody will say, oh, you know what you're doing, and I'll say, oh, I've just been to a lecture or this, that and the other, even if I've not. Oh, what are you studying? You tell them, and it's like, oh, that's very interesting. And you're like, yeah. Men like pretty girls, but I think they like someone with brains too. It draws them into you. Yeah, I think I'm on a different level now.
Tonight in Mansfield, Holly has arranged to meet a man she's rinsing.
He likes a very glamorous, over-the-top, the Essex-type look, very glamour girl. I met this guy in a nightclub, and we exchanged numbers, and things have just gone on from there, really. He's going to be treating me to hopefully some nice gifts this evening, so we shall see.
And would you consider something like tonight a date?
I kind of see it's more like a business meeting rather than a date if I was to give it a name. But you know, these guys do see them as dates, so that is why I call them dates.
Is there any romantic attachment with this guy?
I just don't believe in the whole lovey-dovey, you know, fairy tale type of romance. I don't think it really exists. I always make it quite clear that we're friends. I never try and lead him on much, but you know, if people have feelings for me, then that's not my problem, that's his. Obviously, he's got to have some feelings for me because I need him to keep coming back, but I'd feel quite sorry for him if he fell in love with me, really.
Danica is back home with her family for the weekend. She plans to turn her internet rinsing into big business, and she's getting ready for a Skype call with one of her admirers.
I just put a bit of makeup on. He likes to see my makeup quite natural, really.
Danica never meets her internet admirers in person. She just chats online and tweets. This means she can make money anytime, anywhere.
They pay by every 10 minutes. So like 10 minutes is £50 and then 20 is obviously 100 and so on and so forth. And they get to choose what they talk about, but obviously it can't be any adult content or anything like that. I've sometimes heard like wives or especially children in the background. And that's definitely strange, and I draw the line at that. I think, I can't do that. Hello?
Hello?
So where are you again?
I'm sitting on Morrison's car park. It was the father's birthday party.
Oh, it was really good, thank you, yes.
And what did you have, beef, turkey, lamb?
Beef.
Beef? Yes, I had a bit of beef. Waited for this all day long.
Oh.
This client is one of Danica's favourites, so he's getting a buy one, get one free.
She's coming.
Sophie is Danica's twin sister.
Hello!
How are you,
I'm good, how are you?
I think what I had trouble getting over is why would someone want to pay to speak to her? However, after actually getting involved in some of the calls, I actually understand why people do it, and I think it's because some people are actually alone and they just want someone completely random to come into their lives to make their lives a little bit easier.
What do you call me?
Pretty
one. Yes. Pretty one.
While Sophie is happy to join in, she's aware of the potential dangers of her twin sister's new business idea.
I wouldn't feel you safe meeting with anybody at all.
I mean, I've come home to you, haven't I, saying this guy's offered 20,000 just to have a meal with me. You know, what do you say to that? But why risk it?
They could do anything to you, and I just wouldn't want to take the risk.
Just to speak to you two has made my life today.
Aww. Love you.
I love you more than you love me. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Holly's meeting tonight's rinse in a local restaurant.
Hi there, you're right.
She researched him on the net and discovered he is a travelling salesman.
You look nice.
You do too.
And solvent enough for further attention.
It's quite nice in here, isn't it?
It is, it's a nice place.
He's made it to a third date because he never arrives empty-handed.
Here's your scarf, by the way, that you asked for. I hope it's the right one. Obviously, there's a few other things in there as well.
Are you spoiling me? Yeah, it's definitely the right one. Thank you.
Good.
That's really nice. It matches the necklace you got me last time. I've got quite a few little gifts. Thank you.
It's all right.
You have to think of something even more special to get me next time.
Could be a plane ticket to Dubai, who knows?
That sounds nice. Yeah, the date's going really well. Obviously, he's a really nice guy, so we're getting on quite well, having a nice conversation. The gifts are lovely. The scarf is the one I asked for, so that's all good. The earrings are not really to my taste. They're nice, but they're just a bit maybe old-fashioned for my taste. He would be a nice guy to go out with, but I'm just not looking for that whole romance, fairy tale made-up love thing. I've got no time for it and no need for it.
Holly's admirer has spent over £400 on drinks and gifts just for the pleasure of 45 minutes chatting with her.
She's got the drive for success, I think, really, which is an important thing. It seems like she wants a lot out of life, which is obviously a plus point. She's obviously gorgeous at the same time, so she seems to tick most of the boxes, to be honest.
What about the two of you? Would you like to see the two of you together?
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, why not? Yeah, of course I would. Wouldn't be here otherwise, I guess.
Danica Thrall is enjoying a trip to the shops.
What about an espresso? Ooh.
But she's not actually going to spend her own money.
It's my favourite.
She's using social networking to rinse exactly what she wants from her admirers. And she doesn't even meet them.
Me and my friend have come here today because I need to top my Amazon wish list up. So basically what we do is we'll like log it down on our iPhone or like BlackBerry, like the code numbers and stuff, and then we can go on our universal wish list, put anything on there.
Danica shows her online followers exactly what gifts to send her.
I could do with a George Foreman. I'd quite like a Dyson.
From a Britney Spears DVD to a tumble dryer.
I think it's exciting that you don't have to wait till your birthday or Christmas. You get presents all year round, all the time, spontaneously.
No one's brought me that tumble dryer yet, though. And that's been on there for a while, and I really want that as well.
Cute. One of Danica's internet admirers is particularly generous.
Nice guy. Not long ago I had my Apple MacBook Pro, my laptop, and some, and this is all from the same person, some diamond Tiffany earrings, some Jimmy Choo's and a pair of Christina Ri's hands, these ones. Just, and I've only ever tweeted him once.
Yeah, good on you.
Aww. I think it's great, but I would always be worried that there's an ulterior motive because nothing's for free.
Free. It is brilliant, but it is a bit kind of like, wow,
yeah? Yeah, but it's something for them, isn't it?
It's their kind of... Yeah, in the head, I've bought her this.
She looks nice because of me.
Yeah.
It's an ego thing for them.
Yeah. It doesn't feel real sometimes. I love doing it, though. I really, really love it. I am getting a bit used to it, but that's bad to be like that, isn't it?
Yes.
Jeanette has been charming gifts from men for years. But now she's working on a bigger challenge, the transatlantic rinse.
Yeah, I've got a friend who lives in New York. I just kept putting on my BB status how stressed out I've been. I know I'd love to get away. And he said, why don't you come over to New York? I just put, yeah, I need to come. And he put, when? And I just put, ASAP. And he said, OK, baby, I'll sort it.
And is this guy just a friend?
Yeah.
Nothing more?
Nope.
Would he like it to be more?
I'm pretty sure most guys would like it to be more, but it doesn't mean it's going to happen, does it?
And are you a master at this, knowing when to put a message on, knowing exactly what to say?
I must be.
Oh, that's nice, Hal.
Holly is visiting her mum and her brother and sister in North Wales.
But, like, if you can put it on eBay, you might get £40 to £50 for it.
Mum Carla is an enthusiastic eBayer, and Holly has brought the spoils from her date with the salesman to be priced up.
Let's have a look.
That is Holly. They're
yours. The start price on them is £30, Holly.
Huh?
And they're stainless steel. I'm a little bit disappointed.
You gutted, aren't you?
I am a little bit, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
I'm surprised that I didn't get more money out of him. I feel like it's Christmas and you're expecting to get a Barbie and you get a Cindy instead.
Disgusted.
Far from being concerned about Holly's rinsing, Carla is supportive of her daughter's unusual way to make ends meet.
I don't encourage her to do it, but like if that's what she wants to do, I can't see anything wrong with it. Because if they want to have this, this girl on the arm.
They know, don't
they? Should read the T-shirt, shouldn't they?
Exactly.
You know, if they're not all that guy, they ain't gonna have that on their arm, are they? Do you know what I mean? It ain't gonna happen in real life. It ain't happening. So, take what you can, give nothing back. Isn't it, Hol?
Is that your motto?
Yes. Isn't it?
Very true.
It's true.
The sky's the limit for a dedicated rinser. Jeanette has rinsed a transatlantic business class ticket. Now she plans to rinse New York. And the man she's rinsing seems happy to oblige.
He's given me $500 this morning to go and get some breakfast. $500 bacon. And yeah, I said to him that we might need some plastic for the shopping, which he laughed at, but I think he will.
Jeanette's friend does not want to be identified.
They are the coolest things.
Yeah.
I just been to
the Swarovski shop. Got a nice new ring. $270. That was fabulous.
As the gifts pile up, Jeanette's friend becomes more and more affectionate. But Jeanette is having none of it.
Don't be mean! Very nice. Ooh, train shoes. They are cool. Yeah, so I got my training shoes. That's just come to like nearly $300.
He's very generous though, isn't he?
Yeah, he's a generous guy.
Bite signs that her New York friend seems to expect something more than friendship, Jeanette continues to take advantage of his generosity.
I'm gonna leave it a home bag and some mugs and some stuff for my boys. Anything else is a bonus.
In Berkshire, entrepreneur Danica is developing yet another new business opportunity. She's meeting her web manager, Alan, to launch her new website. Access to Danica's Twitter, Skype, and Amazon accounts will now be available in one place for the first time.
We'll go through it page by page, check it all. If you're happy, out it goes to the web, and then in this computer we'll check that it's out to the world.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
I'm excited. Okay. Alan's put a lot of time and effort into it to make it look Calvin Klein, which is what we wanted. And of course, you know, the idea is for me to make a career out of it and a job, and therefore that means earning money. You know, we want it to make as much money as we can. Who wouldn't?
But as well as making money, there's another reason for Danica's business ambition.
The industry has been really, really good to me, but I definitely feel like I've been exploited quite a few times. Photographers saying, if you don't sleep with me, then you've not got the job. Or if you don't sleep with me, then you're not the favourite model. And hundreds of thousands of models could vouch for that.
Just thinking.
I'm really excited, actually.
Right.
Yay! I've decided to provide a service that I'm completely and utterly in control of. And that way, I don't get exploited or taken advantage of. I get to do what I want to do. And I'm a lot happier being in control and in charge.
So that's that, you built it, but nobody knows about it. It's your job now to tell the world.
Yeah. Hi guys, just to let you all know that my website has launched. Kiss, kiss, kiss. Fund. It's just about making people aware of it first, and then hopefully I'll get a few Skype calls and start my webcam. Yeah.
And get more gifts?
Yeah.
Never have I ever felt an ounce of guilt.
I believe that most of the men are intelligent enough to realise what's going on.
You have to manipulate situations to your own advantage sometimes.
I'm just using what I'm good at to gain money, just as nurses do.
I don't ask for these things, they offer and I accept.
I actually believe that men take more from me than what I take from them.
For as long as I want to rinse guys, there'll be guys out there for me to rinse.
Back in North Wales, Holly has also discovered a new way to make money out of men. She talks to men online, and they pay her to be insulted and degraded about their income.
Meh.
She's what's called a financial dominatrix. Holly's mum, Carla, is about to see just what her daughter gets up to on the internet.
How come you want to know about this, mum?
Well, at this side of it, like, this could be a worry to a parent, but if it's only done over the internet and they don't know you personally, it's just like this, that's okay.
Ready?
Yeah.
Hello, pig. Can you hear me? I've just received the deposit in my bank account, so you now have my attention for the next few minutes. You're very lucky, aren't you? Have you been very busy in work, have you? Have you been earning lots of money? And do you like speaking to me, do you? Because no other good-looking girl speaks to you because you're pathetic. You're worthless. Little worthless pig. You going to send me lots of money? Well, your last deposit was pathetic, and you clearly don't need that much money because you're way too fat. So send me some more money.
Yes, please.
Right, well, I think you've taken up more than enough of my valuable time. In a bit, loser.
Holly, that was absolutely fantastic. I love that. You was brilliant.
And how people cannot look at me and say, I'm stupid.
No.
People like that are stupid. If they want to pay me £200 for, I don't know, 6 minutes, I think I've been speaking to him. I am a smart woman.
You are a smart woman.
Thank you.
Holly now feels in control, but she didn't always have such self-belief.
I've not always had this amount of confidence. No. I was quite bullied and things when I was in school because of the way I looked, you know, with my ginger hair and glasses and an eye patch and braces. So I've not always had this confidence or this ability to always get what I want, and now I can do it. I'm going to take advantage of it. And girls, I think, should feel well more empowered. They should, you know, they shouldn't never let a guy speak down to them or anything like that. They should, you know, girls should be on top.
Girls,
you know what I mean?
Are on top.
They are. My ultimate dream rinse would probably be very long list of surgery.
A Range Rover Sport, a Vogue.
I like the excitement of what you can get.
I wouldn't expect a new one, like a year old or two.
And then the reward when you do get it.
I'm looking for the perfect image.
All of that makes me feel like I'm alive and it's fun.
But this is one rinse that's not such fun. In New York, Jeanette is struggling to stay in control. She's had an argument with her wealthy friend.
He got a bit annoyed that I didn't want to go out. He said, was like, what was the point of you coming here? And I was like, because I want to. Because it's my life, because I'll do what I want.
Having funded Jeanette's day of retail therapy, her friend expected payback.
He thinks he's got like a hold on me over a little bit of shopping or something like that. A few things in a candy shop and a $270 ring. He can kiss my arse. I thought he was a bit more on my wavelength, but he turns out to be a 33-year-old man in a 16-year-old brain who thinks he can buy women's sexual affection through a few little trinkets. Not a chance, but guys just think that automatically because they just think with that.
But he's not happy, though, is he?
I don't give a shit if he's happy or not. I don't care about him, I care about me. And I'm in New York and I'm having fun.
But Jeanette never gives up on a rinse. Experience tells her that her friend will want to make up for the argument in dollars.
Well, my idea is to get the most expensive Louis Vuitton bag before it turns completely sour.
Oh, shocking. Let's meet in 15 minutes next to Louis Vuitton.
Bring your plastic, bitch. You're gonna pay for this in dollar.
But at the designer shop, the argument flared up again.
Got there, and his attitude just seemed all wrong to me. And he was trying to justify himself, and there was no justification in there. He just say sorry and you was in the wrong, and we'll move on from that, or don't. And he chose not to, so we had a bit of a barney, and I've said I was leaving.
So what have you learned from this experience?
Get the bag before you argue.
Jeanette's American dream is turning into a nightmare. After booking into a hotel, Jeanette is in a reflective mood about her childhood.
My mum was single and brought us up. Her and my dad got divorced. That wasn't a good scenario. And we lost our house, we lost our car, all our furniture, second-hand clothes. I'd get bullied at school. All it has done to me is think, if I can get the things that I want in life, like the nice shoes and the nice bags and stuff, and I can get them bought for me, that leaves more money for me to be able to buy my boys what they want. I don't want them picked on at school like I was and bullied. People who know me, my friends from when I was young and my family and things, know obviously what I went through.
Hold up. Danica is enjoying a day in the countryside with her website manager, Alan.
Okay, can you come back over now?
Danica's newly launched website has received dozens of requests for videos of her daily life.
You can kiss me on a Monday, a Monday.
One of the main ones that they wanted to see me doing is riding a horse.
Why do they want to see you riding a horse?
I don't know. Fans have a very weird kind of imagination sometimes. So shall I just say a little bit to the fans, like a piece to camera, and
yeah,
then...
I know you're talking to a lot of people, but it's got to be like yours to one person.
Like personal.
Yeah, so personal. Really... Think about Terry Wogan and his listener on the radio.
Yeah, so OK. Hello, gorgeous. This is me and Freddie, my pony, and I'm going to go riding on him around the lake so you can see exactly what I do in my spare time. See you soon. Enjoy. Mwah.
Danica's unique business idea is to charge £200 to the admirer who requests a video clip of her. And then her other fans can pay her £50 to view it, hopefully generating lots of money.
Because as far as I'm aware, no one's really done it like this. They all charge for the website per month and get their income through that. But I much prefer doing it this way. The whole idea is to make myself and Danica a brand. Oh. At the end of the day, I want to start making it into a money business rather than a gift business, you know. I like to see it as I'm doing it the right way, and this is a job for me and it's a career for me. If I'm both gaining from the situation, I think it's very, very fair. Fred, is that really necessary?
It's the end of the month and time for Holly to tot up her bills.
I've just started to keep a bit of a record, really, of the guys that I'm making money from, just so I can see, you know, who's worth going on another date with, who is a bit of a waste of time. So I'm kind of doing a bit of a business plan, if you like. So this month I've made £200 off a webcam session. I've been on two dates as well this month with a guy called Mr. Zed, and he's called that because he's very old, and if he was a letter in the alphabet, he'd be that far along in life, he'd be Zed. He's like really old. He's presented me with £150 on both dates, which has been quite nice. Two, four, eight. I've made £950. Plus gifts.
Holly's covered the housekeeping, but has much bigger dreams for her rinsing career.
I'm now taking it upon myself to add an author to my very long list of jobs that I already do. And I'm gonna kind of write like a how-to book. Every girl dreams of being a princess, and I was no exception. However, the fairy tale from which the princess comes has one major flaw, Prince Charming. He does to girls what porn does to guys, fills you with false expectations. He does not exist. I want to teach women how to do it. What's the point of scrimping and saving your whole entire life when some muppet down the road is going to pay you a grand a month to live like a princess? Now, I guess you could call me your modern day fairy godmother, as I'm going to give you all the information you need to fulfill your wildest dreams.
Do you think this is something that should be encouraged then?
Definitely. I've never been as happy as when I'm doing this. Any woman can do it, whether they're old, fat, thin.
My advice will seduce his bank card and transform you into the modern day geisha.
Guys, you know, they're a bit deluded. They think that they're miles above women, and it's not true. They need definitely putting in the place, and I'm gonna do that, and I'm gonna make all the women do it as well. Guys will probably hate me, but girls are gonna love me. And I'll make loads of money off them all. 21st century princess, the gold digger.
You do something to me.
Rinsing enables some women to live like a princess, but the lifestyle has its pitfalls. Manipulating men is a game with high stakes, as Jeanette has discovered. But after years of rinsing, she has no plans to give up the lifestyle.
I can't be a normal, average person and be happy like some people are like that. I just couldn't. I'd be dead inside. I'm not doing anything wrong. I'm not breaking any laws. People are going to fall for it. That's their problem. It's like people fall for marketing ideas. They do, because they're stupid. They put a bit of glitter on something and all the birds go running at it and buy it, and it's the same shit as last week. It doesn't really matter. It's like me. Throw a bit of glitter on, get my roots done.
You do that, voodoo that, you do so well.
In one of their favourite London haunts, it's taken Jeanette and friend Maria just minutes to spot a potential rinse. This Dutch businessman was drinking alone.
What do you do? What's your business?
Yeah,
show us. I love it. In my apartment, I have a spiral staircase. You can do them in mine.
Even though Jeanette lives in a rented flat with a perfectly good staircase, she just can't resist the thrill of the rinse.
He comes here a couple of times a month. I'm here every week. So next time I'm here, we'll contact each other, we'll meet up, we'll go for a meal, and let's be friends.
And are you providing them a service?
Yeah, I'm speaking to him. I'm being nice to him.
That's your service?
Yeah.
If you ever want to have a nice one,
yeah. You have to give me a pound. So this is the start of my new staircase. You are the witnesses to this.
Next week, big ladies who eat online invite you to watch and enjoy My Big Fat Fetish at 10. But coming up, you can't get him on the BBC, allegedly. Everyone's favourite dictator is in with Alan Carr.